everyone, Crafting Vicky here with you, and today I'm here to participate in Blog Hop to celebrate the birthday of a colleague in Canvas Corp group, designer group. And so the theme of the Blog Hop, because it's her birthday, is about her journey, basically. So I went online and I tried to find a quote that I liked and that I wanted to put in my soul book, because I figured this would be a great make for my soul book, since well, it's about the journey, and to me, my soul book is a lot about that. It's about my journey this year and how I see life in general and how I see things coming up. So the quote that I decided to use is, "The only impossible journey is the one you never begin." And it's from Anthony Robbins. And I thought that was the best quote ever, because it's really true. And we tend to be afraid of doing stuff, and then we never actually do it because we're so afraid of it. So I thought this would be a great quote for this. So I printed it out, and I'm thinking I'm going to handwrite it once I get there. I'm trying to handwrite more in this journal, so we will see how this progresses. So I took out a bunch of the different papers that I had from previous projects that I've done with for my journaling and all kinds of stuff like that. And most of them come from the Wanderlust paper set from Seven Gypsies. I'll be putting down in the description box below the link to the products I'm using. And I was thinking, I really want to use, I figure with the journey, I thought suitcase, and that's the first thing that came to my mind when I heard of this. So I really, really want to use a suitcase, and I just had purchased this wonderful, it's a stack of suitcase, and it's architecture. It's the new line from Seven Gypsies, and they're just amazing. The texture on them is just amazing. And even the packaging you can reuse, because look at that in the back. It's just wonderful. So it would be perfect. And I'm thinking that I'm going to use it. I'm going to use it for a journal. One of the traveling journals, maybe. So anyway, I thought this would be great on there. And I also got this, which is the clock. And it's also from the architecture line. But I'm thinking of using this as a stencil. So I'm thinking that I'm going to be putting it maybe here and then stenciling. And we'll see how that goes. So the first thing I'm going to do is tear some paper and stick it down. But I'm thinking I need some more paper, because I don't have all that much. So I'm thinking I'm going to add that to the pile. And I might as well use some... I also have some book texts that have been given to me. And I'm thinking that it would be cool to use on there. So maybe a few pages. And I think if this is German, so it'd be kind of cool to have that in there. And maybe this, which is Asian, or maybe more, yeah, this one, it's more aged, so I think it's gonna look good. So let's get this going. So like I said, I'm gonna be tearing paper and sticking it down, and to do so, I'm gonna use my Liquitex. It's the gloss, medium, and varnish. I love that stuff. If I can get it open. Okay, so. And just gonna go and stick stuff down. And you know, I like to not have it perfect on the edge. So. But if I can, and it's torn for the rest, it's okay. Like this piece was already, that's pretty good for that. that one. And it's okay if there's holes and stuff in it, because I'm gonna be doing other stuff as well. So it's perfectly fine if it's not totally covered. I'm gonna be putting paint on it, and well, probably sprays, the Tattered Angel sprays. I love that stuff, and you can use it as paint, and it's just amazing. So that's what I'm thinking I'm gonna be doing. Big chunk, so otherwise it's gonna take forever, because this is a big journal. And if you're curious to see what a soul book is, well, go and check out I'm doing this in a playlist, so you can go and check out my other the other videos I've made. And actually the first one that I made, and the second one as well, has aired by now, so you can go and check that out and see what it's all about. If you haven't heard of her, I found this via Chrissy B. She does My Beautiful Creative on YouTube, and I just love her channel. I came across it by accident, very happy accident. Sometimes YouTube recommends channels and stuff, and she was one of those recommendations, and I was so happy that I actually went and checked her out, because she's very, very creative, and she shares her tips and techniques freely, which is amazing, because those techniques would be awesome to actually use in a class. So yeah, I really love her. So I'm curious, guys, to know what your journey is about. How would you qualify a journey? What does it mean to you? Is there stuff that you're thinking that you should absolutely do and you haven't done yet? There's just so much I want to do and so little time. Work really gets in the way of doing stuff. That's okay. It's part of life, right? Okay, I'm gonna totally need to use more paper. This won't be enough, that's for sure. I'm trying not to put the pieces right next to each other so that I have more contrast. and I don't really mind what the image is showing because I intend to use some gesso on top to kind of push it everything back a bit, so it really doesn't matter. And like this little hole, I don't really mind. I just want most of it covered. So that it's gonna look more fun. And this is also a great way of using all my little scrap piece of paper and such from other projects. So I think I'm gonna use another sheet just because I can. As well, use this one has fun colors, different ones. Okay, so I just have to do something with this big middle piece. This would actually be pretty perfect there. So, right there. And then maybe I can put this right here. And sorry, you're hearing my son. I put a sign up and they always... Actually, it's my husband. I'm always disturbed. Every time I put the sign that I'm doing something in the garage, of course, he has to go and come and... He's really annoying. They can still hear you, you know? Okay, so I really like how this turned out. I still have this piece. We're going to be leaving this, and I still have that as well. So I'll put that aside. This will be awesome for another project. And I don't think I'll be using my Liquitex again, so I'll put my brush in the water, because otherwise it gets very disgusting and gooey. I did really good actually with the edge, except for one area. The rest I actually managed to find pieces that I could use. So let's just cut this off, that little extra piece. And like that. And it's pretty much dry. So now I just want to put a bit of my white gesso. This is a really cheap gesso. It was $6.97 at a local art store. So it's $6.97 for 32 ounces. So very good deal. And just gonna dry brush this. Over, just to push it back a bit. I did that in the traveling journal this month, which actually is aired yesterday, and I discovered that I had lots of fun doing that, and I thought it really looked amazing afterwards. So I think that must be now one of my favorite techniques. It's funny how you don't try out stuff and you see other people use it, and then you actually try it off and you love it. Does that happen to you? I'd be curious to know. There it is. It's still a patchwork, but I love it. It's kind of more to the back. And now I'm thinking, let me put my suitcase here, my big clock, and then write my sentiment on this side. And take a lot of room to write it. That's dry. Make sure it's not stuck anywhere. And so, because I want to put the lettering in black, I'm thinking I'm going to use some black to do this. So what's amazing with this is you just peel it off like so. And I'll stick it right there, I think. So I'm gonna put the suitcase like right there. And so you just kind of peel it off like that. And then you can reuse it, which is awesome. So let's do that. I'm gonna put some paint here. don't want my black to be too weird. Push some of it elsewhere. Grunge it up a bit. Then carefully remove this. And there is my clock. Beautiful, I love it. Put it back. Just give it a wipe. You ready to go? The next make, and I actually love it more than using my regular stencil, so you totally should go and check out those products. I guarantee you're gonna love it, and on top of it you could use it as well as a sticker if you wanted. And like I said, you can reuse the packaging. In this case I'm gonna put it back in this packaging, but you could use it. So now I've got one page that has a lot of black, and so I'll put some black here as well and tone it down with the baby wipe. This little piece that's lifting and it's bothering me. Just put it. Oh, actually, let's just put. Where'd it go? Let's just use some glue from a glue stick to put it down. And I don't want it too black because I was thinking of writing in black, but at the same time it couldn't be as white as it was because it wouldn't have worked with the other side. Like this. Just wipe my hands because I tend to put it in stuff that I shouldn't, and then I'm stuck having just won't stick. Annoying little piece. Okay, and I still have some paint. So let's just put that in my font book that I'm not progressing in. I totally need to just bite the bullet and just put slap paint on all of the pages, but I kind of started it with the scrap pieces of paint, and I never have enough to actually get any. I've been working on this, I think, for a full year. Okay, so let's put this away. I really love this. Now I want to put my suitcase. And I can use this packaging as well for something else. So I'll keep that. And now this is the sentiment that I want to put on there. Thinking I'm just gonna go for it and write it. So let's find my black brush. No, this is not the brush. Yeah, this is the brush. So so now you see the date that I'm actually doing this filming. That's okay. I like this. And I think I'm actually going to leave it as is. I was debating whether or not I'm adding anything to it. And I'm liking it. And if I add something and I mess it up, then I'll be really upset with myself. So I think sometimes it's best to just let stuff be. And in that case, this is it. So this is my spread. So this is the spread. I don't know if you can actually read it, It's a bit dark, but you can easily read it when it's open like this, on my end anyway. So that's my spread. I really love it. It tells you about the time, and you've got only so much time to actually try to begin things, because if you don't, then it's going to be too late. So go for it. Hope you like this. If you do, please do give me a thumbs up. Don't forget to leave comments down below. And to go on my blog, because that's where you're going to find the link to the blog hop. So please do go and check it out. And so yes, and I'll be putting down in the description box below the link to the wonderful products that I've used. And so yes, that's it. Hope you like this. Don't forget to leave comments, thumbs up, and subscribe if you haven't already. Bye folks.